Hey there, this is Akshay Madan and welcome back to a new video. And in this video we are going to continue with our matplotlib series, and this video I think it is the last video. And in this video we are going to cover the imshow function that is used for showing your images, and you can also use this matplotlib for reading your images, right? So first of all we need to import the matplotlib.pyplot as we usually do. So as you can see, I'm doing it and I'm importing it as PLT. Then after it, I'm using this matplotlib.image. I'm importing it as mpimg, that is matplotlib image. This function is basically used for reading your images, right? So you can read your images in two ways, that is using OpenCV, that we can say CV2, and you can also use matplotlib, and that's why we are importing this line, right? Now, first of all, let's see how you can read your images using matplotlib. So for reading your images, you have to use this mpimg that we have imported, and you have to use this function that is imread. And here you have to define the location of your image. So as you can see, in my files, I have imported the five image files from my local machine, and I have put them here, and I have just copied the path like this, and I have pasted that path over here. So this is the line for importing your image. So let's run from the starting. So I'm running this line, then let's run this line, then this. So after this, my image will be imported and the image will be stored in this img variable. Now I want to show my image. So plt.imshowImage and plt.show, that we usually do. And as you can see, I am able to see my image, right? So this is the image that I have imported. So this is the original image. Now let's use OpenCV, that is CV2, that is computer vision, for reading my images, and we will show our images using matplotlib only. So for that you have to import CV2, then you have to use that same thing, but CV2.imread, then you have to paste the path of your file, then plt.imshow and the name of your file variable, then plt.show. So as you can see, this is not the image that I want to see, because if you will see 15.jpg, originally the color is yellow over here. That means the OpenCV is not showing me the correct image, and there's a reason behind it. So you need to remember that OpenCV reads the image in BGR format, but matplotlib reads an image, or you can say interprets an image, in RGB format. So after reading your image by using CV2, you have to convert your image from BGR to RGB, right? So that's why I'm converting this image using this function cv2.cvtColor, and you have to define that image, and you have to use cv2.colorBGR to RGB. Now when you will show this img CV2, then you can see that original image is being shown. So you need to remember that you have to convert BGR to RGB if you are using OpenCV for reading your images, and using matplotlib for showing your images, right? Then after this, how you can change the aspect. So aspect is basically a ratio between height and width, right? So if I'm keeping aspect is equal to 1, I can see the original image. Now you can change this aspect from 1 to, you can take it 1.5, and from 1 you can take it 0.5, and regarding that your aspect ratio will be changed. So let's change my image. So okay, I have not changed it. Okay, let me change it over here only. Let me keep it 0.5, right? So my height and width ratio is decreasing. So let me start running it from here. So import CV2, then reading your image, then showing your image in BGR format, then converting the image into RGB, then showing the image in RGB format, then you have to, yes, now this line. Okay, IMG is not defined. Okay, what is the issue? IMG, where is my IMG? Okay, over here. I have to run this also. Okay, now my IMG is ready. Now let's run that. Now as you can see, the height and width ratio has changed and my image is little expanded, right? So now let's move on to the next thing, and now I'm using a subplot for displaying multiple images in one single plot, right? So for that I have to import multiple images. So I think it image 1, image 2, and this will be image 3, and 3, 4 and 5. So 3, 4 and 5, yes. So let's run this cell. So three variables are ready with the images. Now I'm using plt.figure, then subplot, which I've already covered in the previous video. You have to define the dimensions of your subplot. 2 by 2 means rows, comma columns. Then this is the index of your graph, 1, 2, 3 and 4. That means I'm drawing 4 graphs, and these 4 graphs are containing different images. So IMG4 I have not defined. Okay, let me copy this line and paste it in the next line, and let me make it img4 and let me make it img6. Yes, let me run it again and let's run this cell. So as you can see, four different images can be shown. Now the last thing I want to show is the color bar. Yes, so color bar, you can define it. So you just need to use plg.color bar and it will give you a color bar that your respective image is using. So I've also changed the aspect, that's why you are seeing it a little compressed image, and you can see a color bar over here also. Now there is one more thing, that is cmap. So you can use different cmap. So as you can see, this is a color bar, but if you will cmap, if you will use cmap as gray, then you can see gray color bar will be shown. You can use different how you can find what are the different values you can give for cmap. Just write something wrong value over here and let's run it, and you will be able to see different values that can be possible, right? So let me take yellow, orange and red. Let me copy it and let's give it here. Let me run it. So as you can see, the color bar is yellow, orange and red. So this was the basic function of cmap and color bar, right? So I think this much is enough for this video. And yes, if you have any doubts, you can reach out to me on my Telegram channel and you can post any doubts, right? So I think this much is enough, and till the next content, keep coding, keep innovating, and thanks a lot.